This channel is not becoming a Five Nights at Freddy's channel. We have enough of those. I'll probably make some more videos regarding the games in the future, but this is mainly a creepypasta channel. Thank you, and enjoy the video. So, my top 20 jump scares video has blown up quite a bit, which is nice. In case you don't know, I read pretty much every comment I get. On my top 20 jump scares video specifically, there is one sort of comment that appears quite regularly regarding a statement I made in the video about Foxy. Theory that I always found very stupid. I mean, he's a robot that wants to kill you! He's not good! People seem dead set on trying to convince me that he is indeed a good guy. Well, guess what? I thought I would make a video expanding my reasons for why I just cannot believe this theory. And if you are a hardcore Foxy fan who can't handle people saying anything negative about him, then please leave this video, because I know that you're just gonna get offended. So let's begin. First, let's go over the popular theory that tries to explain why Foxy is a good guy. It's common knowledge that Five Nights 2 is a prequel, and anyone who says otherwise is just wrong. And in that game, people say Foxy is just trying to give you a hug, since his arms are outstretched or whatever. People also say that the scream he emits is him shouting, "Freedom!" Let's listen to the scream, shall we? Now let's listen to it slowed down. Now fast. Now in reverse. Can you hear anything? Because I sure can't! What I think this is simply desperate fans looking way too deep into things. So, back to the hugging business. Let's just ignore the fact that Foxy's jaw is obviously open, indicating the fact that it wants to bite your face off, and let's just focus on his position. He basically runs up to you and dive bombs you straight in the face with outstretched arms. What do I have to say about this? Well, there's one thing these quote-unquote theorists never mention. And what's that? Let's look at Toy Chica's jump scare. Her arms are outstretched as well. I mean, look at that. That looks even more like a hug. How about Toy Bonnie's jump scare? It's the same thing. How come no one ever brings this up? Oh, I guess Foxy is, you know, super special, right? He's different. Right? Now, I guess you could tell me that, oh, it's just the toy animatronics, their AI is different and they're all good. But listen to this. Foxy is not a toy animatronic. Mangle is. And Mangle bites your face off. So, they're not good. Now, we transition into Five Nights 1. The theory goes that Foxy, who, according to the theory, caused the bite of 87, is hiding away in Pirate Cove with a broken jaw because he feels guilt over causing harm, since he's just so innocent and kawaii, right? The theory goes on to explain that Foxy cares for Mike, and if Mike looks at him too much, Foxy will get nervous and run into your office for whatever reason, and if Mike doesn't look at him enough, Foxy will get worried and run towards the office to check if you're okay, and because his voice box is apparently broken, he screeches, giving Mike a freaking heart attack, killing him immediately. And here's why it's simply not true. First of all, we never get to know who caused the bite of 87, and I applaud Scott for not revealing it. Sometimes, too much of something is a lot worse than nothing at all. So we never know if Foxy was the one who caused it. Although, considering the fact that the old animatronics from the second game are locked away in parts and servers during the day, makes it seem fairly unlikely that they would have caused it. Since in Night 6, Phone Guy tells Jeremy to
wear your uniform, stay close to the animatronics, and make sure they don't hurt anyone.
Since the toy animatronics were the ones being used during the day in Five Nights 2, it seems a lot more likely that one of them would have caused the bite, presumably by biting Jeremy, because he's nowhere in Night 7, and you're instead playing as some dude called Fritz. Why else would they scrap the toy animatronics and keep the old ones? If Foxy really bit someone, wouldn't they want to throw away the one who actually caused it? So with that said, let's talk about that broken music box and the broken jaw. So the theory goes that Foxy screeches because of his broken music box. Question: does that mean that everyone else's music boxes are broken as well? Because they all emit the same screeching noise. Of course, some could say that Foxy's voice box is broken because he's out of order, but wouldn't that mean that the other animatronics' voice boxes would be broken too? That can't be the case, since they're used during the day. What, are they just on stage screeching? And regarding the broken jaw, it's actually not broken. If you slow down Foxy's jump scare, you'll see that he actually opens his jaw to screech at you. And finally, we transition into Five Nights 3. Foxy looks just like how he did in Five Nights 2, minus the fact that he's, well, burned. He also makes the same sort of outstretched jump towards you. I don't really have anything to say about this though, since it is a hallucination or something. And that's all I got. If you still think Foxy is a good guy, you know what? I won't mind. You're entitled to think what you think. What I hope to achieve with this video is to make those who believe the theory to see things from a new perspective. Now let's all be friends down there in the comments, alright? Alright? Thanks for watching, everyone. Take care now, have a fantastic day, and stay awesome. Goodbye.
Hi, Billy Mays here with Zorbies. Unlike sponges that smell, Zorbies is odor-free and leaves a path of clean.